Man, I gotta lose some weight. Alright, this is day one of the trip. I'm in Tennessee right now, heading into Georgia, and then I'll end up in Alabama tonight. When I was originally planning the trip, I was really going through and scrutinizing how far I was going to travel, how long things were going to take, where I was going to stay, what I was going to see. And it was kind of taking the fun out of it. It's kind of stressing me out a little bit. So then I got the house, closed on the house, and during the process of moving, came across a piece of land that was available right across the road and started that process. And here this past weekend, we moved, signed for the new property, and yeah, are trying to get settled in the place. So that happened 3 days ago, and this will be a nice way to kind of get away and decompress from all of that. Thursday night, I'm staying in Biloxi, Mississippi, right on the Gulf in a hotel. It'll be kind of like a refresher night. I do have a reservation for that, but the whole rest of the trip really is up in the air. I kind of have a general route of where I'm going to go and some things I'd like to see. Have a little list, but, you know, we'll see what happens. This right here is the Chickamauga Battlegrounds. I'm in Georgia now. I was right by the state line. As you can see, when you go through these state parks and things like that, the posted speed limit signs have got to be recognized.
So we made it to Summerville, Georgia. There's a place here called Paradise Gardens, I think is what it's called. It was a guy's property, and he just started finding stuff around town and making art out of it, and then they kind of turned it into a tourist attraction for the area. So we're gonna go check it out.
Church, which was the first level, and then the other four levels above it he built it. We can't go in because they said that it's kind of unstable, but it is pretty neat to look at.
Yeah, they said that the bands REM and the Talking Heads came out here and did videos back in the day.
Creations and things, and he said, I think that'd be a great setting for the video.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't think we're allowed to go into that part of the building, though. Said that he used to collect bicycles and repair them and give them to the kids in the neighborhood because he wanted to make sure that every kid had a bike.
So maybe tomorrow I'll find my it's hard to vibe, but we breathe. We breathe. I wanna breathe in an open mind. I wanna swim in the ocean. Wanna take my time for me.
Summerville, Georgia, stop off and see Paradise Gardens. It's really interesting. People here are super nice. They know all about it. Sorry?
I said y'all looking for a place to get a bite to eat.
We're actually going to push off and head down to Roanoke.
Oh, okay. Wonderful.
Yeah, we're trying to take all the little side roads and stuff like that, so... Yeah, we're going to head down to Alabama, Tuskegee, Alabama, the national park, and then we're going down to Point Washington in Florida, Louisiana, Mississippi, and then cutting back across. So, you were the first stop. Well, we just left Paradise Garden in Summerville, Georgia, on Rannis Street. And it was really interesting. If you guys are ever in the area, you should definitely stop by. I'm going to leave a link to their website down in the description of the video. They are a not-for-profit organization, so, you know, they accept donations, and there is a small entrance fee that just goes into, you know, keeping the lights on and things like that. But it's really cool. If you're coming from out of town, the girl Josie that was there, she was telling us that they have, like, a little B&B. Or like a little cottage that you can stay in. I think it's only the one, so, you know, it probably books up, but they may have a link on their website. But it was really interesting. It was really cool. I found it online, and I thought it would be cool, but it honestly blew my expectations away. So that was the first stop of the trip. Now we're pushing off to Roanoke. It's about 2.5 hours south, and it's just a small little town. We're going to stop there and probably grab a bite to eat. There's supposed to be a little cafe that's got really good food. So we're going to go check that out.
We decided to take a little back road out to Roanoke. And we've been sitting here now for about 20 minutes. And this gravel sucks. We've only been on it for about a mile. And I've been sliding all over the place. And, of course, there's a really big semi-truck right behind me, and he's going to stay right on my ass. So if I go down, well, it's been fun. Damn it. I'm getting fucking pelted by gravel. Man. Well, we came out of the other side unscathed, but that was sketchy. It's kind of like riding in snow. Back tire felt like it was kind of fishtailing. All right. So this is our list of different places we're stopping and going. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday we end up here, and then Friday, Saturday, Sunday are all kind of up in the air. We have some basic ideas, but we're not sticking to any kind of agenda on purpose. Next place we're going to go see is a place called the Tater House. I don't even remember where it is. So I think we're only about an hour away from the Tuskegee National Forest where we're going to try and camp tonight. We're going to stop, I believe, at three places between here and there. I think this is it right here. Yeah, this is it. This is the Tater House, the historical house in the area. Built in 1920. Yeah, it's supposed to be a historical house, but I thought it was going to be open where we could go in and take a look. Kind of like an old cabin. I guess this one's kind of a bust. Go to the next one. No, it looks like somebody lives here. There's stuff on the porch, so there's mail in the mailbox. Huh? You can't always trust in what you find on the internet. This was supposed to be a cool place to come and take a picture. Yeah, not so much. Well, that place was a little bit of a bust. Not every place is going to be a diamond in the rough. But, you know, still nice to get off the bike for a couple seconds, stretch your legs. You are here. So right now we are in the Tuskegee National Forest somewhere. The only sign we found so far was for a horse trail. And there was nothing talking about camping. No symbols on the map or anything like that. So right now we're on, I don't know, it's like road 906. This is where my GPS took us. It says down here we're supposed to run into something, but I guess we'll just have to go down there to find out. Campsite. I think we just passed the campsite. If I can do this without falling over. Campers, yes. Yep, this is our campsite. This is actually pretty sweet. Kind of liking this.
So we made it out to the Tuskegee National Forest. As you can see, it's pretty dark outside. We went out exploring some of these little side roads trying to find some form of, you know, official building or checkpoint or something, and apparently that This national forest doesn't have anything like that. It's just kind of a free-for-all. You camp in designated sites. It's free, which is pretty cool. Just not used to that. So we did end up wasting some daylight. It was pretty adventurous, though. But we got our tent set up behind me. I'm not sure if you can see it. It is pretty dark. But we did, 303.5 miles? 303.5 miles today. We are in Tuskegee, Alabama. And tomorrow we shove off and we're heading for the coast of Florida. So that's going to be a pretty epic ride too. I'm not sure how many, a few hundred miles, like 250 I think, or something like that. But I'm sure we'll be adding to that because we like to go off the beaten path a little bit. But all right, yep, just letting you guys know how the end of the first day went. All right. About to head out of the Tuskegee National Forest. We're heading over to a hillbilly mall. That should be interesting.